What did the song make you feel? What did it make you think about? What memories or people do you associate with it? Keep this in mind, and I'll come back to it in a bit. When working with middle and high school age clients, building rapport can be difficult. They're in Erikson's stage of identity versus role confusion. This is a time of disorientation and comparison for many. Often, this time is even more difficult for adolescents coming from different backgrounds as they figure out how culture fits into their identity. Navarette and Jenkins call this cultural homelessness. Trust can be difficult in this stage, especially for those dealing with past trauma, anxiety, and depression. Insecurity, past bad experiences, and identity search make it hard to trust anyone at this age. Music, as Karen Skean so beautiful put it, is a body language. From this ancient evolutionary origin, it remains a powerful bonding tool for human beings. Music can have a powerful influence. It allows for bonding and connecting on a different level than just words. Because of this, I want to propose an intervention using music to build rapport and trust with clients, as well as connect on a cultural level. Music has been more and more incorporated in classrooms, but often the emotional component is missed. Music has been found to impact mood, communication, and emotional understanding. In counseling, the counselor-client relationship and multicultural competence are imperative to a positive outcome. Music allows individuals to connect to their roots and culture as well. Hip-hop and rap music are a great example of this. Generally, music has been found to have an impact in various forms of therapy. However, the connection between music, the client-counselor relationship, and culture has not been explored so much, especially in those in the identity versus role confusion stage, and those attending counseling to deal with trauma, anxiety, and/or depression. Keeping multicultural competence in mind, this inspired my proposed study. I propose to use the first 10 minutes of each session listening to and discussing a song shared by either the counselor or the client. Songs in different languages and from different cultures are encouraged. Based on my counseling site experience, I propose to use 8 subjects in the age range of Erikson's identity versus role confusion stage, dealing with anxiety, depression, and/or trauma. I'd randomly assign 4 clients to an experimental group and 4 to a control group. I give them a pretest on a Likert scale of 0 to 10 of the items shown, and then the same items on a post-test 8 weeks later. I expect for pre-intervention ratings of comfort with the counselor, comfort in opening up in session, comfort discussing cultural factors and importance of music in life will be likely different for each individual client. However, after the intervention, I expect higher ratings for each client on comfort with the counselor and comfort opening up in session. For those of different backgrounds, I expect ratings and comfort in discussing cultural factors to increase, while for majority clients, I expect it to increase or stay the same. I expect the importance of music in the participant's life to stay the same or increase, as they see music helping them to connect and heal. Remember the thoughts and feelings you experienced when first listening to the song I shared? I believe music has the potential to create a very special client-counselor connection and trust. The study has the potential of helping use something universal, music, to help counselors connect with clients. With this age group especially, music can help build trust and comfort in a counseling relationship. Those of minority background, those with cultural confusion especially, could benefit from music interventions in counseling. Limitations of the study include a small sample size, which can decrease power and external validity. There's also no control for gender and exact matching of ages, which can skew results with an age range like this. There also is a lack of control or matching for the exact type of mental health concern. Trauma, anxiety, and depression are a wide range. Future studies may look at these items individually, match for age, consider gender differences, and look at the impact of music in groups.
But I'm hope someday.